Coming up, I'll show you how to use Azure and Azure Stack to dynamically scale applications between your data center and the public cloud, while keeping all of your data on-premises and handling massive, unexpected increases in traffic. Azure Stack is Microsoft's hybrid cloud platform that gives you the flexibility to run some or all of your Azure-based infrastructure within your data center. The user and developer experience are consistent across Azure and Azure Stack, from the portal to a consistent DevOps model, so that the same application and infrastructure can run in either cloud without changing any code. Now, a core advantage to using the cloud is that you get access to scalable resources that can rapidly match fluctuations in demand, especially when coupled with cloud-native container orchestrators like Kubernetes, which provide us with a consistent deployment framework, access to cloud-first development paradigms, and efficient use of cloud resources. With on-premises infrastructure, we typically have to plan capacity around known peaks in demand. When demand exceeds capacity, you're left with service disruptions because on-premises infrastructure takes time to deploy and integrate, leaving it unable to react to changes in customer demand. You may have to put up with decreased customer satisfaction and lost business to keep costs in line. A hybrid application deployed across Azure and Azure Stack gives you the best of both worlds, using local infrastructure to handle normal traffic and taking advantage of the public cloud for instant scale when traffic spikes. To show this in action, we have a fictitious company, Northwind Health Insurance. They need to account for two types of spikes in demand. They handle an expected increase in traffic in December for healthcare enrollment, but there's always unexpected peaks in health insurance claims that are hard to predict due to bad weather events or illness outbreaks such as measles or the flu. To better withstand unexpected claim events, we've migrated Northwind's claim management system from an on-premises application to a hybrid application that meets Northwind's corporate policies. Here's a look at the application infrastructure. You'll see that we've split the app across Azure and Azure Stack and are running the web layer on Kubernetes clusters. Automatic scale from Azure Stack to Azure is made possible using Azure Traffic Manager, Azure App Insights, and an Azure function. We also have a hybrid network in place using site-to-site VPN to keep data secure in transit. Here you can see our application in Azure on the left and an Azure Stack on the right. In Azure, I've deployed my AKS cluster, Traffic Manager, Application Insights Workplace, and an Azure Container Registry to store my container images. I've also got a jump box to inspect resources in the hybrid network. In Azure Stack, I've deployed a SQL Server to handle the data layer for this application and to keep customer data on-premises. I've also deployed a Kubernetes cluster using the Kubernetes Marketplace item, as well as a specially structured virtual network to bridge the two clouds. The Kubernetes Marketplace item is available in preview and is consistent with Kubernetes clusters in Azure since it's generated by the Azure Container Service engine. The resulting cluster will run the same containers as AKS in Azure. You can learn more about Kubernetes on Azure Stack at the link shown. Now, using Application Insights Live Metrics with my claims management system, I can see app performance data across Azure and Azure Stack. Application Insights is natively integrated into my application through the .NET Core SDK. We can see that traffic right now is low and pretty steady, and I have three Kubernetes pods running, two in Azure Stack and one in Azure. Now, to test scaling from Azure Stack to Azure, here I have an application that will simulate a large number of users attempting to file a claim on Northwind's site. Let's kick this off. And in a few seconds, you'll start to see traffic spike. We'll return to this in a second to see the outcome. In the meantime, let me explain what's going on behind the scenes to make sure all of these users can file their claims. Application Insights allows us to aggregate telemetry from both on-premises and cloud-based infrastructure. We can set up alerts for any number of metrics. In this case, we're going to use an alert based on the number of requests per second to determine when to scale to Azure. The App Insights alert allows me to configure a condition and an action group. This particular action group uses an Azure function to direct Azure Traffic Manager to route new claim sessions to the Kubernetes cluster in Azure. We've managed to implement this functionality with a minimum of code. This Azure function uses an Azure Service Principle to enable or disable the Azure endpoint based on the scale action chosen. So let's switch back to see how our app is doing. Back on the App Insights dashboard, you can see the majority of traffic is being routed to the Azure Kubernetes cluster. Additional pods in Azure have been added to support the increase in traffic. In addition to adding pods, we can use the cluster autoscaler in Azure to add or remove additional nodes from the Azure Kubernetes cluster as needed. You can learn more on how to enable this at the link shown. This combination of App Insights telemetry, Azure Functions, and Azure Traffic Manager, as well as Kubernetes scaling, allows our web application to handle all kinds of changes in traffic patterns. Now remember, to comply with Northwind's corporate policies, all of our customer data has to remain on-premises. To allow the Azure Kubernetes cluster access to our database on Azure Stack, we've created a VPN tunnel between Azure and Azure Stack and planned out our virtual networks so nothing overlaps. To prove that data does indeed flow to the on-premises SQL server, I'm going to go to Northwind's website that's running on the Azure instance and file a claim. you can see the green bar that says this page is running in Azure. This form has already been pre-filled for me. I'll go ahead and submit my claim. I can see that my claim was submitted successfully, and sure enough, I've been given a confirmation number. To show you how my data is stored on-premises, I'm going to go over to SQL Server Management Studio, hosted in a jump box, since my SQL server isn't accessible outside of the hybrid virtual network. We're connecting to the database server with a locally routable IP address on-premises. I'll write a query with recent claims. My recently submitted claim is right on top. Even though my claim was submitted through the Azure portion of the application, I was able to securely route my data to a SQL server on Azure Stack. So what we saw was that Northwind was able to create a new hybrid application that was able to scale across clouds while keeping their customer data in their data center. Through this process, we were able to use Azure Traffic Manager, Azure App Insights, and Kubernetes to adapt to spikes in demand, all while keeping our data on-premises to comply with corporate policies. We were able to efficiently use our on-premises resources and scale to Azure to meet customer demand. To learn more about Azure Stack, AKS, and your hybrid options, check out the link shown. Thanks for watching.